that proof, but I'm going to do it. I would like to show that it has really important applications. I mean, even in a very particular case. I remind again what I said at the beginning of a series of lectures, during first lecture, that there were important applications of gross lemmas and others to fully to Harnack and Wilder estimate for solutions, which in turn brought to classical solvability for Bellman equations, which have a really close relation to control of diffusion process. This is the way how I came to PDE. My PhD was in probability, and it was control diffusion processes, and I worked with equations, and then I saw it is shorter somehow to avoid probability if it is not degenerate for a non-degenerate case. And I again remind that I have a link because there is something misleading. I try to find a Google reference to steel pipes, which was, so this was 2004 year steel prize of American Mathematical Society for seminal contribution to research. It was to Evans and Krylov. Seminal means something very significant because they also award for lifetime or lifelong. That means to people for whom they don't expect more serious results. Seminal means for people who still long way to go. And this was true, maybe not everybody knows, but it is good to know for this summer period for 3 months. Four new PhD students under direction of Professor Krylov, some defended, others are going to defend. So this density is more than one new PhD per month. So this is would be envy for, junior or as matter. Okay, so the link, correct link, so first I tried to find the link and I found some with extension UK, it is United Kingdom, maybe Ukraine, but Ukraine. But because link was something was very fault, and so there was Evans, was distribution, who got Steel Price, and all of them are famous mathematicians, but when I clicked to Krylov, it shows a different picture, different name, Nikolai Mitrofanovich Krylov, instead of Nikolai Vladimirovich. So correct link would be, for more information, www.aes.org. You can find also more information there, okay, not that. Notices 2004, this is the year for which this award, and 04 I think it is for April, notices once per month, and then C-O-M-M, steel, and another E, PDF. And what I want to bring to attention, so the information, something about the importance of this contribution, and the response for a recipient of this prize. And Evans, in particular, Nick also later developed boundary second derivative estimates, something at which I completely failed. And so I want to let's explain what it means. This was estimate for, it is called Krylov's lemma, let me formulate it first, so you can see the relation to Krylov's lemma. Now,
consider only equations
for but for simplicity, but it is actually a model case. So if you have this estimate, then more or less standard tricks help to
extend it to more general only second order terms. Zero in half ball of radius 2r. This is intersections of ball of radius 2r, take center at zero, and I prefer to have half ball
to have xn positive,
so xn bigger than zero. Okay, and u is zero on the boundary, or let me write in such a way. So this is ball. Half ball, x prime is in R n minus 1, first n minus 1 component, xn goes vertically up, and so x has components x prime xn, and then what is the estimate? So this is ball of radius here 2r, twice smaller ball, but we need an assumption on the boundary, so I write it in such a way. Ux prime 0, that means xn is 0, so here we have a portion at which u vanishes like this. Okay. So u is 0 here. So assume identically 0, but of course we restricted only to bottom of this boundary, so we have such conditions. And then estimate looks like this. Then oscillation. Oscillation over smaller half ball, so B plus R, so smaller concentric half ball, B plus R, here over, I don't assume
positivity.
This is something what I discussed at the end of the talk. When we consider oscillation, then we can, okay, let me write it first. And I write it in the form
convenient for iteration,
2 minus alpha, oscillation. Oscillation is supremum minus infimum over half ball, radius 2r, in a bigger half ball, u over xn. So what you can see here, because we don't have first order terms, denominator is also solution to this equation, and also vanishes on this part of boundary. So we have ratio of two solutions, both vanish on a portion of boundary, and this estimate that what is here, alpha, they exist, alpha depending only on dimension and the ellipticity constant for conditions, which are just measurable. And this constant is positive. Okay. So this is a key estimate that Professor Krylov used an exciting technique conditional diffusion processes, and so processes under condition that it does not reach the boundary, and then corresponding equation was degenerate, but still it probably has a wider scope of application. This came as a byproduct, and the equation was degenerate, but still there was kind of Carnot or Hilder, so this was like this. And so if we iterate, this was also part of argument, when we iterate and take here smaller value, we can write oscillation over smaller half ball, u over xn, and less than rho over r power alpha. What I when I wrote something similar, I had coefficient 2 here. I don't have it now because I have 2r bigger ball times oscillation supremum, half ball to r u over xn. So if you use mean value theorem, right side is estimated through gradient, because
you at xn 0, 0. So in right side we have a gradient.
Oscillation and also problem.
Oh, oscillation, thank you.
Oscillation.
And if we separate, if R is big and put minus alpha to left side, we get something like Euler estimate for gradient. Namely, let me continue. I first show how it works. If you go further and consider what is here, what happens on the bottom. On the bottom we have, so if I denote B prime, so prime means I have n minus one dimension, so B prime would be this ball of radius r, but ball in dimension n minus one. So if I just look at this and take limit as xn goes to zero, by definition of derivative I get, let's see, there is a couple of this, okay. Mostly. Okay, so it implies oscillation B plus B prime rho. B prime. So B prime is Bohr of radius. B prime rho is Bohr of radius, or just set of where x prime less than rho. This is in R n minus 1. So it implies that we take limit oscillation over B prime rho dn derivative, and this is at x prime 0, when we take limit x n going to 0, same as in right side, and now it is less than rho over R power alpha. And here, by mean value theorem, we can get oscillation B plus to R, and here I can take DNU. So if we separate something stronger, it seems rho is arbitrary, and also we can take center, not necessarily at zero. When we apply to different centers, we get greater continuity for normal derivative on the boundary, just from fact that so it is something what we don't have for interior, inside of domain. This is why this argument does not use for interior estimate Evans-Krylov for non-linear equations, something more was needed, the convexity. Okay, so this is what comes in application to fully non-linear equation. Let me write it in such a way. F second derivative, and here I use letter V, and is zero. So the fully non-linear means not quasi-linear it is, but under assumption of convexity, which is used only for interior estimate. For boundary estimate, it does not need it. Again, if you have it like this, in a half ball B plus to R, and V zero on the boundary, let me call it this portion, or I can write it same way, V at X prime zero is also identically zero, or equal zero on gamma to R, and gamma to R this blue part. So this what we have. What means we can assume F is smooth, it does not a big deal. Important to have constants which don't depend on smoothness. Ellipticity means if we formally take Aij, but it will depend on everything here. If we take function partial derivative df, dvij, Vij are variables in place of which we take put mixed derivative, that it is satisfies uniform ellipticity condition. So if you have a solution, plug it into that, we have AIJ dependent solution, but we don't need, we don't care what is dependence. Important that is this matrix with eigenvalues strictly positive and bounded. And so this is how it is used. Assuming everything is smooth, apply derivative, so take k between 1 and n minus 1. That means one of tangential directions, so x prime is, so this is, and differentiate with respect to, take derivative with respect to, apply derivative. Then what happens? Use chain rule, then we have sum ij differentiate with respect to intermediate variable aij, and then we need to take this and differentiate with respect to the to k, so we get dij, and I call it uk is, or let me write dk u separately like this, 0, so by chain rule. In this half ball plus 2r, and since we have 0 and we differentiate only in tangential direction, we also have not u, it is v. This is something what I wanted to call by u. And v dk vx prime 0 is also identically 0. So we have it like this. And so we are under condition of this lemma, and this implies, and so we consider this as uk, and what we have, uk, we have normal derivative, so this implies, if I put it this way, that dkn, second derivative, u, at x prime 0, or I can take oscillation, it doesn't, so oscillation over half ball radius r less than, so as r goes to 0, it is
v here or u?
Oh, v, thank you, v, because it was v, rho over r power alpha, and now it is the oscillation of just, let me take b plus into r of just second derivatives, maybe maximum of, so I don't care. If r is 1, for example, then in right side we have, oscillation of second derivative. In left side, when we divide by rho power alpha, we have the order constant for second derivatives. Not all of them, but what is missing? We also have dij, v at x prime 0, identically 0 if both ij less or equal n minus 1, because we differentiate this twice in tangential direction. We have second tangential derivative 0. If one derivative tangential, another normal, we also have control. The only derivative which is missing is the second normal derivative. But we have relation from here. We either use mean value theorem or implicit theorem. From this relation it follows only also that second derivative has the same. So what we get, if I separate it, write oscillation, let me write it separately, rho minus alpha, oscillation over half ball, second derivatives, v, or actually not half ball, here is prime, but in fact, in combination with the integral estimate, we get it also, it is prime, less than constant, because now I cannot write just this, I also include the second derivative r minus alpha, and this is oscillation of second derivatives. So in right side we have second maximum of second derivative. In left side we have Euler constant for second derivative.
There are also interpolation inequality, any weaker intermediate semi-norm. We can estimate it through small constant times Weber constant, and so on. So it gives implies that V is of class C to alpha up to the boundary B in combination with something. Not right away, but this was one of key points and, which looks like nothing to do, but it is something that brought to very significant applications. For Bellman equation, smoothness up to the boundary is needed, for example, but also one can do something like this for when we have, instead of zero derivative value, when we have normal derivative zero, what we do, need to do instead, differentiate in normal one case n. There's some those who are interested, it is I don't want to say, give more, much more. There is some notes in my homepage. So this is UMM EDU. So at the bottom of my homepage, there are some links to notes. If you just go this way, then to notes, then 1991, there are some lectures about this stuff, kind of PDF file. There were some problems at the end of these notes. There are not all of them are solved in either way, so it is all, but this part, historical part is there.
I'm not sure. Do you have math in your
web
address?
M-A-T-H somewhere?
Just
like
that.
Oh.
What? Do
math.
You
need to put on
math. Your double U, let me see.
Math.
Double U. Thank you. See. Oh, yeah. It is, you don't need to put actually double U like this. It comes if you start. Thank you. But I think links to homepage of speakers are somewhere present. Okay, so this is kind of applications which are not looks like everything is simple. What before, I mean, this was progress at the beginning of 80s. In preceding work by many others, I don't have time to talk about it. There were extensions or actually for case when for Laplacian or for equations with Weber coefficients. And the strength of this was no assumptions on AJ. And now I write a formulation of what I did last time. And so we can see how it matches with this, and it, in which way generalizes. And also I wanted to emphasize what I really use, because there are some variants maybe which are applicable to maybe to manifolds and to some other things, if we have just a... okay, so this, let me see, 7273. So what I formulated last time, let me use, was like this. It was helium, I formulated as 6-2. We have two positive solutions, so U and V. Both solutions LU is LV, zero in John domain. D in RM. So we have Y zero on the boundary. And we have
u is 0 on gamma to r, which is intersection boundary with goal of radius to r, centered at y 0. If you look at this picture, it is just here half space, and your domain is more general. Okay, so this we have. Then what we claim, then supremum. And dr is a notation for dr is d intersected with ball radius r centered y 0. When I prove it, I assume r, y 0 is 0. Okay, so then we have then supremum, so everything is positive here, so supremum over dr u over v less than constant ratio u over v at z 0. So what we have, z 0 is in definition of joint domain, there is constant k, and there is center z 0, and in definition we can connect each point to center of this domain. If you take point x, there is a center, one center for each point, and we can connect it in such a way as in think of this curve as a axis of a twisted cone. If it is straight line, it is just a cone. But what I want to emphasize here, it is a constant. Some people asked me when I wrote applications, here is something what doesn't allow us to iterate it. Dependence z0 and r, and they come together. I mean, if I make r smaller and smaller, then constant becomes bigger and bigger. Not like in this case. Here, if I just rescale it, I replace x by rx, I have a square constant here, which I cancel and get the same equivalent statement. And so here there is no dependence on r. And I cannot say it right away here. And it is not true if you just do it in, for your domain. So, and what we had, and the last time I proved what was, so from in theorem 6.1, was a particular case when v identically 1. If I just formally plug it here, of course it is true. Forget about other sanctions, and we don't have denominator, and so we have estimate kind of what people normally say, Carlson type estimate. And so this is what we have. And also we have to solve the estimate for u and v when we approach the boundary, both in terms of distance to some power, if we estimate from below distance to power c1, from above distance to minus c1. Okay, so this is what we have. Now, let me see. 6.2. Proof or sketch, but as I said last time, it is not harder than what was when we had it this way. Okay, so proof or sketch of proof, if you think it is not convincing. So take, we can assume r is 1, just by rescaling. Y 0 is 0, I already wrote it. And also, we can multiply u and v by any constant, we change nothing. We can also assume u z 0 and v z 0, both 1, equal to 1, and then we need to estimate ratio in a smaller, so what we have it R, and this is a bigger domain. This is portion where this U is zero. Okay, so this is, okay. So here we have only U is zero, V not necessarily zero. If also V is zero, then we can put upside down, and I wrote it as corollary one, then we can estimate supremum through with an n squared times infimum. This is, looks like Harnack type, but it requires also V zero in the boundary, kind of symmetry between U and V. Okay, so now what I need from John domain. So this is kind of one of main applications. Let me erase it, and I will not repeat again definition of John domain. And here I don't need it to full extent. I need only property which comes from definition. As soon as we have it, estimate when V is one, but also use the properties of John domain to have weighted estimate for solutions through distance of boundary. So what we have such property. So D is a John domain. Implies the following: if x0 distance to the bar less than h, let me write, so d is a distance to the boundary, x0 to boundary, if it is less than h, and x0, of course, I assume it is in d, then we have the following. Then we have the existing ball of radius h. This sum center, I call it x1, just a different point, but it belongs, lies in a in the set dh, intersected with ball radius k0h. Radius proportional center to x0. K0 was just 2k plus 1. K constant in definition of John domain. And dh means d intersected with d intersected with set where distance bigger than h. So when we are away from the boundary, we have a two-sided estimate, so we can reach center in finite number of steps by kind of Harnack chain. And so we have estimate both from above and below. And so what we really need, we have, I can draw again now, this is a picture. So this is y0, which is 0. Now I have, this is radius 1, d1, and I have it also like this. This is d2, RS1. Okay, and so in between, if, and we have, so u is 0 everywhere on this part. I use the blue color for all the picture, but U0 only here, and inside U and V positive, and satisfy your equation. So what we get from case which we proved, when V is 1, from here in 6-1 it follows, but when we apply it, we may apply to different centers. So if we put something in between, say d 3 over 2, we still have either we are away from the boundary or we are close to the boundary. If we are close to the boundary, we can apply the theorem with different center, so we still have some room. So we have u is
less than some constant n0 in d in between 3 over 2.
N0 is, I should write u times u at z0, but z0, u z0 is 1. So we have u controlled from above here. We have some gap between the boundary. And also we have lower estimate. It was theorem for one second part, but lower estimate, which I will need it for from below, v bigger than n1 minus 1, h power c1 in dh. dh is a set where distance bigger than h. So estimate is in terms of, I can put here distance, but it is if distance bigger than h, then we have it this way.
Superscript or lower? The superscript or the subscript?
H. Let me see. DH. Oh, thank you. So, with me. Yeah. DH upper index says we are away. And lower index is a definition for intersection with both of some radius. Thank you. Okay, so this is, and so we have, if you want to, if we are away from the boundary, ratio is estimated, but it is estimated in terms of distance. But we want to have estimate up to the boundary. And so this is introduce such sequence. So RK, say 1 plus 1 over k, this is how radius will shrink. So we will consider sequence of domain when k goes to infinity, they shrink to this to d1 from above. But simultaneously, we will stay away from the boundary, but with a different rate. So here we approach radius 1, but not too fast. Not too fast, so the increment if you take two neighbor values like 1 over k square, but for each k we take 2 minus k. It is much faster. Okay, and then denote the following. So take tk is intersection of drk. Intersection with let's see d less than hk. So this is maybe I will draw a separate picture how it looks when we if domain is flat, it is like this. And so what we have, so this is part gamma 2. And we have, when we consider intersection, we have, so this is radius RK, so this is B plus, or say D RK, what is it? But also I TK, when we have, so this is radius RK, and when we stay away by distance hk from bottom, we have this part below is what I call tk. This is such strip which is close to the boundary. What is above is uk. U is a kind of upper set. We split this portion uk like this. Okay, and then what we have, we always have estimate. Let's see, I need to figure out one. Oh, yeah, I still have plenty of time before to complete this. Okay, so what we have, if I denote, okay, so UK is,
just use my phone. I found that it was here. So UK. This complementary part is DRK intersect this set where distance bigger or equal HK. Oh, I don't care, it is not open. It is but just because when we do estimates we can take closure. So this is how we split it. What is good about UK, it is a little bit away from the boundary. We can use integral estimates. And then what you have, if I denote, so these are all notations. And MK denote supremum over UK, U over V. And here I always have, since I have control of both U and V above and below in terms of distance, I always have some constant which depends on K. Less than some constant which depends on K. You see, to be honest, I need to start from K equal maybe to stay inside of D3-2, but I don't mind if I just, let me just take K starting from 4. So initial value would be 1 plus 1 fourth, so we stay inside of, step inside of D3-2, and so but actually we need it for a big enough K. So we need to show that this MK is controlled for each K. Because what happens when K increases? RK shrinks to... So D1 would be something like this. So this spherical part shrinks to D1, and this gap decreases, so HK goes to zero, and when we take limit, not exactly limit, limit would be this D1 plus spherical part of boundary. But if you have it uniformly for each click, we are done. Okay, then you have here like this. Okay, let me write, once rewrite again what is here. So we have your, we have upper estimate this way. Let me mark estimates which are more important, so I also convenient for myself. I need to use something, and I know it's somewhere here, but I need to spend time to find it. And another thing, I want to use this, but let me write it in specific way when I have put HK. HK is 2 minus K. So I do it in such. So this is one estimate, and V is bigger than V bigger than N1 minus 1, some small constant, 2 minus K C1. I just rewrote this estimate when H is AK, HK. HK is 2 minus K. And this is on UK. So here, ratio, if you estimate it just from here, we will have growth like 2 power, not growth actually, it is... okay, so we have dependence like this. Okay, now let me see what else I need. I probably have to erase this part because after simplification I came here. My goal is now to get a uniform estimate for MK. So MK, and so this part also I need some space for calculations. Not. Okay, introduce a function like this. Let me use one more line here. So consider function double UK.
which is U minus NK times V. What we know about this function, it is less or equal to 0 on UK. On UK, this is by definition, or by this property, U over V less than NK, so multiply by V, and we have, so difference is negative, positive. So we have it here, if we consider two neighbor pieces, but also I want to have it on the bottom. Then how it looks like? We have such strip. We have gamma 2, and we have this TK, which is, so this is, let me write, draw this way. So this is set, we have strip TK, so this is zero intersection, so I had it also here, bottom, but I want to show how this is TK, and now I want to extend it to strip TK plus 1, which is like this. So this is a distance HK, and then it becomes twice smaller. And so what we have above, we have W less or equal 0 on the top, and also we have it here. So if I use blue color for W, so it is negative here. If you shrink to set where W is positive, it lies inside of this. And then what I want to do, how this strip looks like. I draw it as if it is fat. But in fact, it is what is here. The distance between two concentric spheres is of order, so I have put it here, RK minus RK plus 1 is kind of or close to 1 over K square, or of order. And the distance to the boundary is 2 minus K. And so I can use Gross lemma, so you see, if you think of this as something positive or some hint, it can come only from this portion. And we can proceed step by step. Here, H is HK. In each ball of radius, so for each, if I take 0, so what really happens if I, let me show how it looks. It is actually very slim, the thickness is of order 2 minus k, and the length is of order 1 over k square. So we may, if we proceed, we can go to the steps k0h, if we decrease, so this take distance k0h here, and take maximum on the boundary here at some point, say x0. And this is, then we can use Gross lemma. Why? Because what we find, if we take a ball of such radius, it contains a ball proportional of radius r, so this is x1, which lies in the complement where we have estimate, which lies in this blue area. So this is h. So this is what happens when we do the intervals in dh means completely in the set where distance bigger than in UK. So here is this part belongs to UK. So this is UK. So that means when we take maximum here, it's strictly less than maximum here, the constant beta less than 1. And the number of such iterations, is of order
I don't want to write it explicitly because it would involve K0, but what is important is of order, so length, so K minus 2, and thickness is 2 minus K, so of order K minus 2 times 2 power K, which is huge. If K is big, it is very big. And so what we have when we keep going, we get after a finite number of iterations, we get an estimate. Let me see, so I used this property of John Domain was needed me just for this step, and I can repeat it so many times. So of order, that means I can put some constant small or not. If it's small, but still multiplied by something that is big. Okay, so let me just write what follows from here. And this was the only purpose I needed, the part which I now erasing. Okay, now, so what comes from here? Iterating Gross Lemma. Gross lemma, and the number of iteration is indicated like that. Beta is like exponent minus constant less than 1, and when we adjust it, we can multiply, so C is positive constant. We can get the following, WK. WK less than, and what is WK? It is U minus something. For U, we have a rough estimate, and we don't need much more. So it is very rough construction, but still works. W is less than N0, which because U less than N0. And then when we go through iteration, we get exponent how many times. Put here constant minus C2. It may be small constant, but still depending only on what is prescribed, k minus 2, 2 power k. This is how many times we can iterate it. And this is 1 uk plus 1. This is how we shrink, so how w shrink. It is, but you see where it is, becomes strong. Here 2 minus k appears in exponent, and it appears with minus. So it goes to zero extremely fast. And then we can be very generous with a v. For v, we do nothing, we just use what it is, how it looks like this. Actually, I wanted to write this way. When we combine it, for if I put here k plus 1, I need to put k plus 1 in front of them. So what we get supremum over u k plus 1 w over v less than what I denote by epsilon k. And let me just plug w less than this constant. V bigger than this, only k plus 1 instead of k, and just put them together. So this estimate divided by this, that means 1 over this. So I have constant which is n0 n1 times 1, so exponent, I have it here minus c2, k minus 2, 2 power k, this was for the numerator, and for denominator, we have this. But now upside down, I need to write 2 power kc1, but let me write in such a way. Instead of 2, I write, it is already exponent, logarithm 2, it, exponent of logarithm 2 gives me this 2, then k plus 1, c1 times k plus 1. So this is exactly this expression with k plus 1. But what we have, it goes to zero very fast. This growth is very moderate, linear growth. And here we have
to k with minus, and everything in exponent. So this is an estimate with a huge reserve. I'm using it for twisted column. In fact, this reserve helps to cover case of twisted Hilbert domain when alpha bigger than 1/2. And 1/2 is critical. For 1/2, you don't have this estimate. So but this is just by the way. Now, how to complete this? Now we have almost everything. I wanted to have mk plus 1 uniformly bounded. Okay, write it this way, mk plus 1. By definition, it is supremum over uk plus 1 u over v. What is u? From here, I had somewhere here, and u is, look at this, u is, can be derived from this expression, u is double u k plus mk, u is, write separately, so u is mk, u is mk v plus wk. When I put it here, I have mk plus supremum over uk plus 1 wk over v, which I just estimated. So this is less than mk plus epsilon k. And so if I want to, and this is something what I can denote by mk plus 1, if I want to keep track of constants. If I have it for mk with mk, then I have mk plus 1 estimated by this. And now if I just put in everything and keep going, I have uniformly supremum over d1 u over v is less than limit as k goes to infinity mk, mk increasing, or let me write mk in what it would be. But in fact, let me write mk. Here, a bit not monotone. If I write a limit, I need to explain, but I don't need it. I need only a bound, which is monotone, which is less than. I started from k equal 4, take n 4, which is a prescribed constant, plus some, when we do summation, epsilon k, would be sum k from 4 to infinity epsilon k. And this is, of course, converges because it is super fast going to zero. And call this estimate by m, and then we are done. So this is our estimate. So supremum u over v, m, and n, because I assumed u z0, and v z0 was 1, so we have this estimate. Okay. But this does not allow iteration. Why? I have a simple example, but I easy to believe actually that we cannot do iteration, because what happens actually, I think I have 10 minutes. Okay, so let me just so what do we need to complete what we cannot iterate it. That means if we zero, so we cannot get estimate for oscillation with constant not depending on R. But this is why more general domain R, not more general. John is more general than uniform. So this is how uniform domain comes to play. This is definition. Domain
and dimensional is uniform. Is a constant K if for any two points x1, x2 in this domain there exists a curve connecting x1, x2 line in D such that first, I think length of this curve constant times, I use same constant for two properties less than proportional or of order distance, or I can say proportional because we always have inequality that it is bigger than difference. But another thing which instead of close to shore of river and your and speed of this is smaller when we are close to battery or to shore and higher if you are away. So the best strategy would be go inside. So when we go inside, we stay away from the boundary and we can move by bigger steps. And so if you want to count number of iteration, this would be better than if you go parallel. So then for each gamma, and the worst case when both x1 and x2 are close to the boundary, we need to start and end these points. And so in between, we may have for any point y, we have initial segment and last segment, and then minimum of gamma x1 y, and gamma x2 y, length minimum of these two lenses, less than constant times distance y, where for each y in gamma connecting x1, x2. So this is more general than John. If you have this, we can take some of interior point and look at it as center, but also it is kind of scaling invariant. If it is scale, we get the same property. And no mention about center. It can be unbounded. For example, it can be half space, which perfectly works. But what makes it possible to iterate? There is a lemma which I tried to find the reference in our joint work, which I mentioned. And I really hate formulation, proof, but we needed it to see, 7, I need to say 2, 7, yeah, lemma like this, which I would appreciate if someone tells me the reference. So there are so many references to uniform domains and different people give different definitions. I gave simplest one just with one constant. So, okay, so lemma is like this. If for reference it is lemma 3.3 in joint papers with Hai-Jin Kim. Okay, so what let D be uniform with constant K bigger than 1. Okay, and suppose Y is on the boundary, and what we are is such that domain does not fit inside of ball of radius R. So this is ball of radius R. Not exactly, it may have points on the boundary. So assumption is such that boundary of dr y0 minus ball radius R y0 is not empty. That means there are some points it either intersects this boundary or at least it reaches it. So this is take such R and K one, but it is not completely correct, and of course it is not best constant. But this is actually constant from definition of if I want to use definition John domain without d at x. But okay, something like this we can approximately. So this is take it like this. Then for any r from 0 to r over k1, there exists a John domain J depending on R such that into this center Z with index R, so I try to write them differently, such that, so if I take dr intersection with z is 0, it covers, so it is contained in this John domain. But we cannot just, okay, so, but in order to fit it, it is it should be of size comparable to size of this. So it is in turn is dk1r at no, it is y0, not z0. We don't have z0 here. It is y0. It is again y0. But this is by in dr. So this is restriction for r that we have it like this. So to have it inside of this domain. John domain is center and such that dzr. And this distance actually both distance to the boundary ZR to boundary of D, and also domain somehow concentrated near Y0, it is same as distance to the boundary of this John domain, and we can make it exactly R. So if you use theorem for John domain, and it says depends on dzr, it is just r, and also constant also for the r, so in such form that it enables us to do iteration or to do rescaling, and by iteration we get the same kind of tricks. If you have both u and v vanish on the boundary, and then we have estimate for oscillation, but I out of but this is quite similar. So if you have it this way, let me just right. So this for John domain we have so u, this implies theorem if u is d is uniform and u both not only D, so U, L U, L D, 0 in, say, D, V positive, let's see what, yeah, V is positive, and U is, okay, let us take both, U and V positive, so U is, and V, 0 on the boundary, on gamma, 2R, say, minimum, and V is positive. V is positive in D. Here I get only V. Then oscillation V rho U over V less than constant times rho over R power alpha oscillation over D to R, and this is also DR. So I just write on top. R U over V. So this is something what looks similar to Krylov's lemma. but it not true for a John domain. If you have just a domain like this, disk for Laplacian, take it gamma like this here, L is Laplacian, and we can take Z0 this way. When we approach the boundary from this direction, and take value, say, G is X2 plus. So G is positive here, negative here. And corresponding value is U.
Your P rho and D R, right?
D rho, thank you, D rho. D rho, when we do iteration.
D R.
And here D2R.
Which is
the
problem, but not negative, G.
G is positive above and automatically zero below.
Yes.
Automatically.
You said negative.
Non-positive. I mean, negative means non-positive. Okay. So what do we take? If we take U corresponding to this value, and the value is B, X1, X2, which is just reflection, U X1 minus X2, they're not comparable. If you take, so U over V has jump across gamma, and which is a segment, say, X1 between, so, minus 1 and 1, and X2 is 0. So, and this is just for Laplacian, so L is Laplacian. It is not hard to using symmetry, actually. When we take difference, it must be 0 here, and then figure out. And then we cannot have Gilder regularity. And also, if you think of this as why we cannot have it, when we approach and want to think of it as a uniform domain, these points X1 and X2 may be close, but if you want to connect, we need to go around this obstacle. So this length is at least 2 if you are here. But it should be of order X1 minus X2. Okay, so I think I took 2 extra minutes.